Hi everyone, this video is continuation for the previous videos. Here we are going to discuss about nursing management for the diarrhea. Okay, here we are going to discuss about nursing management for the diarrhea. Here first one we are going to discuss about diagnosis. Okay, what is meant by diarrhea, what are the etiological factors for the diarrhea. Okay, up to that what are the symptoms. Okay, in this previous videos we are discussed already. Okay, here what happens means diagnosis, how to diagnose the exact the infant will be suffering with the diarrhea. Okay, here first one is the history collection. Okay, history collection. Here what happens means once the infant will be coming to the hospital, okay, what is the infant problems. Okay, here we are collecting the history. As a nurse we have to collect the history from the infant. Okay, in this history collection also have the two types. Okay, here first one is the subjective data, objective data. Okay, here why we are discussed subjective data, objective data means here the infant not giving exact information regarding diarrheal problems. Okay, why? Because he is that 1 to 12 months of age group child, no? Okay, here prime first subjective data. What is mean by subjective data means here the infant only giving some of the complaints to the nurse, that we are called as the subjective data. Okay, in this objective data means we are collecting history regarding client, but we are collecting from the history family members or the mother or the any friends relatives. Okay, here the history collection will be two types, first subjective data, objective data. In the subjective data sometimes the infant not giving exact information means we go for the secondary data. Okay, here the mother will give complete information regarding infant. Why? Because she is one of the first caregiver to the infant. No, okay, what is the problem, what treatment or what preventive measures we are taking for reducing the diarrhea, that information compulsory having the mother. No, okay, that's why we are collecting history from the secondary data like family members, mother or the friends, relatives, like that. Okay, here next physical examination. In this physical examination, inspection, palpation, percussion, auscultation is there. No, in these four steps here in an inspection we are assess the means by the eyes we are assess the infant. Okay, by the observation we are assess the infant problems. Okay, now sometimes we are observing only we are getting infant problems. Okay, for example the infant is having the excessive excretion of urine many times or excessive excretion of motion many times, that will be observing. No, why? Because the infant is going to the washroom, excreted the motion, that will be only by seeing only we are understand. Okay, that's why in the inspection we have to assess the client problems, infant problems. Okay, next in this second one is the palpation. What is the palpation step, what we are doing means here we are assess the in the symptoms we are discussed, you know, respiratory rate increased, blood pressure increased or pulse rate increased or low grade fever, like that the symptoms is there. No, here we have to assess the pulse rate. Okay, what is the pulse rate of the infant, what is the respiratory rate of the infant. By keeping the hand we have to place the abdomen, what is the respiratory rate. Okay, next by touching skin of the infant, what is the fever. Okay, if any low grade fever or high grade fever or temperature increased or less, that will be identified. Okay, next in the percussion what we are assessed means in this step we are assessed infant bowel sounds. Okay, now why? Because it is the one problem related to diarrhea. No, okay, here the bowel sound should be abnormal, sometimes increased, sometimes reduced. Okay, for knowing of exact bowel sounds we have to use the percussion step. Next auscultation. Here what we are doing means we have to assess the heart sounds of the infant. Okay, this is the physical examination regarding infant who are suffering with the diarrhea. Okay, next we are going to discuss about stool examination. Okay, in this diagnostic step, it is a very important step. Why? Because here in clinical manifestations we are discussed to know what means the stool consistency should be green color or the yellow color. Okay, in there sometimes the stool will have the pus formation or the blood. Okay, that contents is there in the stool that will be observed. Okay, now what is the consistency of stool? For example, liquid like stool or the water like stool. Okay, that will be identified. Next, here blood examination. In this blood examination, what we are doing means sometimes the infant should be excreted blood with the stool, no? Okay, what is the percentage of blood? Hemoglobin percentage. Next, erythrocyte sedimentation rate, that will be assessed in the blood examination. Okay, this is the diagnosis regarding infants who are suffering with the diarrhea. Okay, next one is the management. Okay, management. In this management, what we are doing means rehydration therapy. Okay, rehydration therapy. Why we have to do the rehydration therapy means one symptom is there, no? Here what is mean, the infants having the regularly or 2 to 20 times excretion of stool, that's why the infant having the dehydration of the skin. Okay, for prevention or for improving the rehydration, okay, here what we are doing means rehydration therapy. Okay, here what we are doing means ORS. ORS nothing but oral rehydration salts. Okay, oral rehydration salts should be provided to the infant. Okay, for improving the rehydration of the body. Next, here we are going to discuss about oral rehydration salts ingredients. What is there? What contents is there in the oral rehydration salts means here? The components is the first one is the sodium chloride. Okay, sodium chloride. Next one is the potassium chloride. Okay, potassium chloride. Next, sodium citrate. Next, glucose anhydrose. Okay, here the contents per liter of water. Okay, we are going to give 1 liter of water with ORS solution means what are the ingredients is there means here sodium chloride is the 3.5 grams. Okay, 3.5 grams. Next, potassium chloride is the 1.5 grams. Next, sodium citrate is the 2.9 grams. Next, glucose anhydrase is the 20 grams. Okay, these are the ingredients have in a 1 liter of water for the rehydration of client. Okay, this is regarding management. In these, we are going to discuss about ORT provide with ORS. What is mean by ORT? Oral rehydration therapy. Oral rehydration therapy. Here we have to provide oral rehydration therapy with ORS, oral rehydration salts. Okay, next here we have to give some fluids. Okay, which is available in the home. Okay, the fluids or the fruit juices we are giving to the infant for improving their dehydration of the skin. Okay, for improving their fluid balance. Okay, for improving their electrolytes. Okay, next here, what means fruit juices? Okay, what are the available in the fruit juices that will be giving to the client? Sometimes we have to provide coconut water to the infant. Okay, next one is the IV fluids. Okay, in these IV fluids, for example, severe diarrhea. Severe diarrhea, nothing but we are already discussed in this previous videos, no? Sometimes the infant suffering with the 3 weeks or more than 3 weeks due to the diarrhea. Okay, that condition we have to provide IV fluids. Okay, IV fluids with the ringer lactate solution or the infusion. Okay, oral ringer lactate infusion. Here we have to give, for example, sometimes the infants are not able to take fluids by the mouth. Okay, the type of condition or the severely having infants diarrhea means sometimes the infants having the convulsions, no, abnormal body movements, or sometimes the infants going to the coma, no. In that state, we have to, for prevention of coma or the convulsions, okay, we have to give the IV fluids, okay, IV fluids. Next, in this management, symptomatic management. Here the symptomatic management, especially anti-emetics, okay, especially anti-emetics. Why? Because for prevention of vomitings, sometimes the infants having the vomitings, the symptom is there, no? For prevention or for control of vomitings, for reduce of vomitings, we have to give tablet andamstiron, okay, tablet andamstiron 8 milligrams, the dosage is the 8 milligrams. Okay, next, if the client, infant having the fever, okay, sometimes we have to give antipyretic drugs. Antipyretic drugs. Here, for example, paracetamol. Okay, paracetamol. Here, chemotherapy. Okay, in this chemotherapy, we have to provide the medications like amoxicillin. Okay, amoxicillin. Next, ampicillin. Next, streptomycin. Why we have to provide, why we have to administer these drugs means for prevention of viral infections. Next, for prevention of sometimes bacterial infections is there, no? For prevention or for reducing bacterial or the viral infections, we have to administer these drugs, amoxicillin, ampicillin, streptomycin. Okay, next, here. We are going to discuss about nursing management. This is the important steps. As a nurse, what we have to do? Okay, for reducing the diarrhea in the infants, what care we have to provide it for the infants? Here, we have to collect the history of illness. Okay, so many infants will come to the hospital for the health checkups or the different disorders they are having. Okay, exactly the infant suffering with the diarrhea or the another disease conditions, how we are identified means by collecting complete history. Okay, by collecting complete history from the mother regarding infant. Okay, after collection of the history, we have to do the physical examination. Okay, physical examination step we are discussed, you know, here in this management. Okay, here the steps is there, physical examination, inspection, palpation, percussion, auscultation. Okay, in the different steps, we have to do the assessment of the client from the head to foot examination. All over the body, any abnormalities is there due to the diarrhea, that will be identified. Okay, next, after that, we have to do the stool examination. Okay, here what is the consistency of the stool? Okay, what liquid or watery like stool are there or not? Okay, what is the color of the stool? That will be identified. Next one is the fluid balance. As a nurse, we have to improve the fluid balance of the, okay, infant. Fluid balance should be maintained. As a nurse, we have to maintain the fluid balance of the infant by providing fluids or the by providing ORS. Okay, by administration of the oral rehydration therapy to the infants, okay, for maintenance of or for regulation of fluid balance. Okay, next one is the, as a nurse, we have to maintain the IVO chart. IVO chart nothing but intake and output chart. How much quantity, how much ml of water or the fluids is taken by the infant by the orally. Okay, next, output means how much of amount of fluid, okay, how much amount of fluid should be excreted per day, that will be identified. Okay, next, record it. After identified, after examination, we have to record in the IVO chart as a nurse. Okay, next, here, personal hygiene. Okay, in this personal hygiene, it is a most important step. Okay, why? Because diarrhea is one of the easily spread to the other persons, easily spread to the other infants. For example, in a family, two or more children is there. One children or one infant will be affected by the diarrhea means that will be easily spread to the another infants or another children. Why? Because it is one of the communicable disease that will be one person to another person easily spreading. For prevention of spread of the infection, we have to maintain the good personal hygiene. okay, for prevention of infection, for increasing spread of infection that will be controlled by maintaining the good personal hygiene of the children. Okay, for example, safe disposal of diapers. Okay, now in the perineal area, okay, in the anal region, as a nurse, we have to encourage the mother for use the hot water, okay, now for cleaning of perineal area for prevention of bacterial infection. Okay, next one is the breastfeeding to the continued. Okay, now as a nurse, we have to encourage to the mother according by administration of fluids, by giving oral rehydration therapy. According to those, we have to encourage the mother for providing breastfeeding. Okay, sometimes the mother will give 1.5 to 2 years of age group infants, they are going to take breastfeeding, no? Okay, that will be continued along with the ORS and some coconut water, okay, some fruit juices. Okay, next one is the here preparation of the homemade ORS. Okay, one step is there, that is the preparation of homemade ORS. As a nurse, we have to give health education regarding ORS preparation. Okay, in the home level, how to prepare the ORS. Okay, that will be encouraged, or that explanation should be given to the parents. Here, 1/2 spoon salt should be taken. Okay, for prevention of ORS in the home level, 1/2 spoon salt should be taken along with 6 teaspoons of sugar. Okay, 6 teaspoons of sugar should be taken. Next, it will be mixed in the 1 liter of boiled water. Okay, not plain water, not cool water, 1 liter of boiled water. Why we have to boil the water means, in the water any microorganisms or any bacteria or any contaminated materials is there in the water, by providing heat, by boiling of water, that will be killing. Okay, for purification of water, simple method, for purification of water we have to boil the water. Okay, after boiling we have to add the 6 teaspoons of sugar, next to 1/2 teaspoons of salt. Okay, this is the homemade ORS to the infant who are suffering with the diarrhea. Okay, next here. Thank you everyone.